You are listening to the Faith Fight Podcast, and today's episode is on critical thinking. Hello again, everybody. Thank you for tuning in to this new episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and as always, I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. And I'm grateful that you took time out of your day to listen to this podcast, and I hope and I pray that it will be a blessing to you. If you know someone else that needs to listen to this episode, you can share with them. Today, we're going to talk about critical thinking. And just as a reminder to everyone listening right now, if you're going through anything at all, whether it's a health situation, if you need help praying for your children, or if you need to find Bible verses to help you in your prayer to find a job, I have covered all of these different topics. And if you want to listen to any of those episodes, you can go into the archives and scroll through the many episodes that I've already released, and you can download and listen to those episodes. It will be a blessing to you. It will encourage you, and you can learn those verses and put them in your heart so that faith can be built for your breakthrough. As the Bible says, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. That's the reason why I've done this podcast, and I formatted in this way so that we can go over the Bible verses every single episode and be encouraged as we listen to them over and over again, and let faith be built in our hearts. In order to get to the archives, you can click the link in the description of this episode, and you can be able to search through every single episode that I've done since day one of the Faith Fight Podcast. Now, just before we get into this episode, there's something that I just want to share with everyone. Now, I've been podcasting for over 2 years now, have over 100 episodes, thousands of downloads, and those are potentially thousands of lives that have been touched by this message of the Faith Fight Podcast. Now, one of the things that people have asked me time and time again is, Chris, I want to start my own podcast. How do I do it? What do I need to do? What do I need to download? What's the first step? What kind of microphone should I use? Etc., etc., etc. What I've decided to do this year is help you start your own podcast. So if you have a message that you want to share, if you're a pastor or a leader in your church and you want to share your own message out there to the world in the format of a podcast, I want to help you do it. But if you don't have a ministry, and if you just want to talk about football or sports or automobiles, which are things that I love, by the way, and you want to start a podcast, I want to help you do that as well. What I did was I created a podcast quick start guide that you can download, and you can read it through, and it'll give you the exact things that you will need to do in order to start your own podcast. And believe me, people, once you read the quick start guide, you will see it's not as difficult as you think. The link to get the podcast and quick start guide is in the description of this episode. Just click it, and then you'll be able to download it, and you can read it through, and you can start getting your message out there to others. This is one of the things that I'm doing for 2021. I want to help other people start their podcast. So there's a link in the description of this episode that you can click on if you want to start your podcast this year in 2021. And believe me, it's not as challenging as you may think. The link is below if you want to download that and see for yourself. But now back to this episode. Now, we need to make sure that we take the time to think carefully about what we allow into our minds. Today, it is too easy for anyone to just go online and say anything, and some people are just so naive that they'll believe anything without getting the truth behind it that will support it. One of the things that I recently heard was that the COVID-19 vaccine is the mark of the beast and that you shouldn't take it. And this makes absolutely no sense for this reason. When we see this lie and hold it up against the scriptures in Revelations, we see that the mark of the beast is mentioned after the church has been raptured and the Antichrist would have been revealed. And the tribulation would have already started when the mark of the beast was introduced in Revelations. So this vaccine could not be the mark of the beast simply because it's not accurate according to what the Bible says. Now, this is the type of careful thought that we need to give to these things that we face today. And that's what this episode is about. It's about critical thinking. So let's get into it right now. The first verse that I'm going to read is Proverbs 14, verse 15. It says, "The simple believes everything, but the prudent gives thoughts to his steps." Now, the word simple here refers to a person who doesn't make the time or effort to think carefully about a situation or decision. If we want to make good decisions, we have to ensure that we are taking the time to think through all of the possible consequences before we follow through with our decision. Next, I'm going to read 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 20 to 22. It says, "Do not treat prophecies with contempt, but test them all. Hold to what is good and reject every kind of evil." Now, we shouldn't make fun of those who don't agree with what we believe, but we should always examine everything, checking their word against the Bible. We can be on dangerous grounds if we just disregard what a person says if they speak the truth. Instead, we should carefully check out what people say, accept what is true, and reject what is false. And next, I'll read Acts 17, verse 11. It says, "Now these Jews were more noble than those in Thessalonica. They received the word with all eagerness, examining the scriptures daily to see if these things were so." And again, that was Acts 17, verse 11. So how do you evaluate sermons and teachings? The people in Berea opened the scriptures for themselves and searched for truths to verify or disprove the message they heard. Always compare what you hear with what the Bible says. Next, I'll read 1 Peter 3, verse 15. It says, "But in your hearts, honor Christ the Lord as holy, always being prepared to make a defense to anyone who asks you for a reason for the hope that is in you. Yet do it with gentleness and respect." So this verse was written in response to Christians who were afraid of suffering for the sake of Christ. Now, Peter encouraged them to be ready to give an answer to defend their faith. In order to be ready to give an answer, you have to think about the people you are speaking to and think about how you can answer their questions in the best possible way to represent Christ. This involves gathering information on who you are talking to, analyzing all the details you have, and thinking about the best possible response from every perspective. Now, this is critical thinking. And we'll move on to the next verse. It's Proverbs 4, verse 7. It says, "Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. And with all thy getting, get understanding." Now, wisdom is the application of knowledge, and knowledge is gained through understanding. In order to understand a particular thing, we have to think about it from all perspectives and consider all possible outcomes. This is why I believe this verse says, "With all thy getting, get understanding." Understanding from all different perspectives, and once you do that, it will accumulate into knowledge, which can translate into wisdom. The next verse I'll read for this episode is Proverbs 19, verse 8. It says, "The one who gets wisdom loves life. The one who cherishes understanding will soon prosper." Now, if you want to prosper in anything that you do, you have to get a good understanding about it. In order to have a good understanding about anything, we need to spend time thinking about it and to know how it works together with everything else connected to it. And when you have this understanding, then you can make proper decisions and think about that area accurately. Now, the next verse I'll read is Proverbs 22, verses 17 and 18. It says, "Pay attention and turn your ear to the sayings of the wise. Apply your heart to what I teach, for it is pleasing when you keep them in your heart and have all of them ready on your lips." Now, one way to apply critical thinking to your decisions is to think and remember what wise people have said about those similar decisions. Think back to when you were in high school, university, or college, and remember what wise people have said about the specific decisions that you need to make, and you can apply those same principles that they applied to what you are doing in order to make the best possible decisions. One of the things that we learn in university and college is not so much the content of what we are doing, even though that is a big portion, but we're also learning the approach, the thinking aspect of approaching those situations and how to think about them correctly to make the best possible decision. And the final verse for this episode is Isaiah 1, verses 18 to 20. It says, "Come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall become like wool." So you might be thinking, what does this verse have to do with critical thinking? Now, let me explain. One great way to develop our critical thinking ability is to talk to great critical thinkers. In this verse, God encourages Israel to talk to him about their sin. So what happens when we talk with God? Let's think about that. To answer that question, we're going to go to Isaiah 55 verse 9. And it says, "As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." And again, that was Isaiah 55 verse 9. Now, though our minds are not capable of reaching the same intellectual capacity as God's mind, by having regular fellowship with God, it will cause us to think at a higher level from God's perspective. And now we're going to move into a moment of prayer concerning critical thinking. So if you're doing anything that requires your attention right now, please keep your eyes open. I'll pray and you can agree with me through saying amen. So Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you once again as we approach your throne of grace. We thank you for your amazing love, for saving us, Lord God, and sending your son Jesus to die on a cross and pay the price that we couldn't pay. We thank you right now as we come before your glorious throne of grace, Lord God, and we worship you and adore you because you are our Heavenly Father and you care for us so much, Lord. So we thank you and we ask, Lord, that you forgive us, cleanse us, and purify our hearts as we come before your presence. And we thank you, Lord, that in Jesus we are made righteous before you, and we thank you that we may approach your throne of grace with boldness and confidence, knowing that you will hear our prayer. And we come before you right now and we commit our hearts and our minds to you, Lord God. I pray for myself and every single person listening right now, Lord God, that you will help us not to be simple or naive in our thinking, but help us to be prudent and give thought to our steps and the decisions that we need to take on an everyday basis, Lord God. Father God, help us, Lord God, to think with clarity and gain understanding, Lord God, that we may move forward and apply wisdom to every decision and everything that we do, Lord God. Help us, Lord God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, Lord God, to discern what is truth and what is not, Lord God. Help us, Lord God, to test the spirits, Lord God, to hold on to the truth and to reject all forms of evil, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, that you're faithful to direct us and lead us by the power of your Holy Spirit. In our down times, Lord God, when we are not doing anything, I pray, Lord, that you will help us, Lord God, to be diligent by studying your word, Lord God. Help us not just to read your word from a surface level, but help us to go deeper, that we may examine it with eagerness, Lord God, and to see the truth hidden in your word, Lord God, that we may apply those principles in our life, and that the fruit of obeying your word will be evident in our life through making good decisions, Lord. Give us discernment and wisdom in our hearts, Lord God, that we'll be able to answer anyone who may have a question for us, to oppose why we believe what we believe, Lord God, and give us gentleness and respect, Lord God, that we may deliver that answer, Lord God, with grace, so that you become glorified and that the answer that we give will draw them closer to you, Father. I pray, Father, that with all that we get understanding, that understanding will be added to everything that we know, and that what we know will translate into wisdom, Lord God. And not wisdom like the world speaks about wisdom, but godly wisdom, Lord God, that is not of this world. That is what we ask for, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that you will help everyone listening pay careful attention to the sayings of the wise, Lord God, and that our hearts, Lord God, remember the things that we have learned from wise counsel and wise people who have mentored us over the years, Lord God, and give us a mind that will be able to remember those things at a moment's notice, Lord God, that we may apply them and put them into our lives, Lord God, that we may be great critical thinkers, Lord God, and move forward and do amazing things for this kingdom of God's sake. And Lord, as we continue to spend devotional time with you and spend time meditating on your word and fellowshipping with you, I pray, Lord God, that your thoughts will become our thoughts, Lord God, that the mind of Christ will be in us also, Lord God, that we may think at a higher level, Lord God, and make better decisions and come out prosperous as a result of spending time with you. So we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise for this right now, and I seal this time of prayer with the blood of Jesus, and I ask, Lord, that you be glorified in all of our lives. In the name of Jesus, we thank you and we pray. Amen. And that wraps up another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. If you were blessed by this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast, go on to Apple Podcasts. Make sure that you subscribe, and you could also write and leave a review on the podcast for others to read it as well. Now, for those of you who have Android phones, you can subscribe and listen to the podcast through Google Podcasts and through Spotify. You can just search the Faith Fight Podcast, and you'll be able to subscribe using any type of podcast playing app that you have on your phone. And as I always do, I create a customized prayer plan for every single episode. If you want to get that, you can click the link in the description, and you'll be able to download the customized prayer plan, which gives you the Bible verses that I went over, the notes that I covered, and also the Bible verses for each day of the week that you can use it for your daily devotions. It's a downloadable PDF. You'll be able to follow every single day of the week, and you can ask yourself the questions, and it will help enhance your daily devotional time. So you can get that by clicking the link in the description. And if you know anyone else that needs to listen to this episode, if you think it will be a blessing to them, share it with them so that they can listen to it and be encouraged and built up as well in their ability to apply critical thinking to everything that they do. And remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day before you go out and fight the good fight of faith. You will hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Be blessed, everyone.